Moses was gone and Joshua was now in charge. Gone was his mentor, his leader, his perceiver, direct link with the divine. And God told him that he was supposed to go into Canaan, a land promised to be of milk and honey. But from looking at it from across the Jordan River, it looked unremarkable at best and terrified at worst. Yet, in those uncertain terms, God said to Joshua, "You must go forward. You must go forward." And that's what God is telling us today. You must go forward into the things of God. You can't keep sitting in the same old place, doing the same old thing. You can't keep coming in here Sunday after Sunday, sitting out in your chair like there ain't nothing you can do. You got to get up and find something to do. There's something for everybody to do. There's something for everybody to do. You got to start moving forward. And just like God might have made some promise to you that you going to have your business and stuff like that. And I'm getting ready to tell y'all this too. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
It is time for you to step out on faith in the things that God has promised you. This is your opportunity for prosperity. Prosperity is here now. This is the time. This is the season for prosperity. If you don't move now, like never before, you're not going to be able to walk into the things that God has promised you. Now is the time for you to step out on faith into the things that God has promised you. God has opened up doors like never before now. Those doors that were once closed to your face, they're not closed anymore. They're open for you to be able to walk right into the things that God promised you years ago. So what you waiting on? What you waiting on? What are you waiting on? That was for me too. That was for me too. But you know what, y'all? I've already stepped out on faith. God has opened up the doors. And when you know God opened up the doors, you don't even have to go looking for it. It'll come find you. And mine's that come and found me. Miss Jeanette found her right on the job. Right in my classroom. Came to her. And I touched and agreed with her and let her know. What you pray now? It came to you. God said he'll let your blessings find you. You ain't got to run behind them. They'll run you down. Mine's ran me down. Mine's came. Some of mine's came right in the classroom too. Came right in the classroom. Blessings is flowing with milk and honey. You're going to miss it if you don't move. I'm going to tell you that. You're going to miss yours if you don't move. But from looking at it across the Jordan River, it looked unremarkable at the best and terrified in the worst. Yet, it is uncertain term. God said to Joshua, "Joshua, you must go forward. You take all these people who have wandered through the desert for so long, and you go forward. Go forward with the promise as I was with Moses, and so I will be with you. I will not fail you or forsake you. Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Be not afraid of what God is doing in your life." We too are being asked to go forward with courage and strength because God has promised us to be with us, guiding us, holding us close. God is here and will not fail us or forsake us. So y'all got to move. You got to move into the things of God. You're holding your own money in your belly. You're scared to go get it. God gonna send some papers through the mail for you to go try and get it. Lord, is this from you? Now you better know it. It's God, and I'm telling you this. But we really don't believe it. That's what the problem is. We really don't believe we can do it. Well, Lord, I don't think I can do it. That's why I had never stepped out, because I didn't think that I could do it. But God already told me, "Be not afraid, for I am with you." Joshua was one of my favorite things of that, "Be not afraid." Every time I read it, "Be not afraid, be not afraid, be not afraid, for I am with you." When I get ready to preach what God said to me, "Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with you." That's what gives me strength to be able to do what I do. Not no strength of my own. That's why I'm able to bring that word forth like I do, because God done told me, "Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with you." Open your lips and I'll speak through you. That's what keep me going. It's time to start taking steps toward being a person like Joshua who can be helped, be God's help, strong and courageous for Christ. And I think I'm at that. You be listening, we're going. We need to be able to accept change in our lives. We need to let go of the past and be willing to move forward, to start fresh, to take a new step or a giant leap when God calls for it. A giant leap. That's what we're going to take. I'm going to tell y'all that. It said, we need to be able to accept change first. We need to let go of the past. That's the thing that holds everybody back. The past. What the past going to do for you? Keep you in bondage? Or be willing to move forward, to start fresh, to take a new step or a giant leap when God calls for it. God can really tell y'all to go someplace. Y'all better go. You better get ready to go. I'm going to start right here. But I want God wants you to be strong and courageous no matter what you're going through, no matter what's bothering you or what's on your mind, what's on your heart. I'm at the finish this next Sunday. But God wants you to be strong and courageous into the things of Him because He's getting ready to move you forward. That's my song, Hezekiah Walker, moving forward. Ever since I played that song, it's fine. Do some for me. Moving forward. I listen at it over and over and over. Because it's a meaning to it. You got to listen at it. What it's telling you to do. It's like it's direction. Move forward. Stop seeing back. It didn't tell us to move back. It said move forward. And when you start moving forward, you're moving forward to the things of God. You don't want to go back. There ain't nothing right there for it.